Well then, hello. I've got my mate with me again. Reddest hello, man hello. We all know. I'm not getting tired hello, of hello. Saying that. Last time we realized Yesod's flaw, and now he's pretty bare bones, except for like 3 key pages. Cause I decided to do Tifereth next, after being inquired by Red to not do Gebra.
Yeah. unless you want like have an episode where you like try for like 2 hours or something.
It kinda sounds intriguing, you know? It kinda does. But I also understand, I tried it twice already on screen, and it was a absolute nightmare. I do have a plan for it, but I think it's just better to wait. So I'm gonna wait. Today we're gonna do Tifereth's Tifereth's second abnormality, and see where we go from there, because we will enter the next chapter from that. So let's go. Okay. Kirby targeted does not act. Give tears to a random sword every 3 scenes. If a character is staggered, activates the scene after. Despair. When a sword of tears to take lethal damage falls into despair next scene. When the abnormality falls into despair, all swords fully recover HP and stagger resist and use special combat pages. If all sword impale the abnormality in despair stage, becomes staggered and target will next scene. What?
Yeah. Look at the enchant one.
Ah, okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, we didn't talk about our setup yet. I'm gonna just run it down real quick after we read this. Gain a speed die. Nice. Oh, that's a tears thing. Enter a state of suspension upon taking lethal damage. Revise to 2 scenes. If this fails, deal any damage to its target while in despair state. The sword will impale the Knight of Despair, dealing damage to her. I'm not sure.
It's pretty easy.
I have no idea how this works, but Dimension Rift.
Who got the one in the...
Huh?
Despair states.
What do you mean?
Like, you need to like, stagger, you need, like, kill the one that's like in that enchanted state.
Well,
which is why I told you to bring fossil other passives, because then this will go really fast.
So yeah, to everyone watching right now, we have a setup of Oscar with a singleton Pierce deck, my Rose deck, and the Kim deck you already know and not love. So let's just Will of the Prescript is. Oh wait, I only have one. Ah, yeah. I kinda wanna use D-Rift. Not bad, I wanna use D-Rift here. And then leap here. You're supposed to use, I don't know, Sharpened Blade here to intercept, and a Flying Sword here because you're funny.
Oh, wait, this thing is good. Ah, oh. It won't stagger.
Alright, Love, Fate, and Justice. Yeah, I misplayed that a little bit, but that's fine. I think I want Love. Yeah.
I mean, both are fine, not really aiming.
Put it in Oscar. What's that state? I wanna know what that state is. Tiers 2. Okay.
Yeah, you just need to like kill the one there. And then like gig, because you will stagger with hits, right?
This should definitely stagger, yeah.
Like what is it that clashing with?
This?
Yeah.
It's clashing with this.
Yeah, just make sure it doesn't boost the clash, because otherwise, you know, it doesn't get staggered.
This shouldn't lose both clashes. And as long as one clash goes through, the stagger will be better.
Yeah.
Gig onto literally anyone, right?
Yeah. Well, just you need to kill the one in the state, or like lose the 1 HP, so... And after they get staggered, after the resistance are, you know, fatal.
Alright.
Make sure you don't get hit by those two. Because they're...
At least not hit too much.
Save that for next turn. Trust me on this.
Great. That was not how I expected to stagger it, but...
Next phase. Now you have to win all of the clash. Now you have to win all of the clashes with the swords. They're now gun cards, so you know, extreme match is really nice against one of them.
Mulinette is safer.
Is it? The blunt one can lose. Right?
True.
Like calculate the damage with like quite the flying sword. Flying sword has plus
5,
three,
9,
5
and,
to 9,
and
6 to 10.
It's risky. It's all around risky. We can look at the intercepts here. Ripple can be used.
No. Well, you probably lose the first clash.
Do all of them use the same thing? Oh, this will be difficult.
It's a gun card, remember, so it gets recycled. Like, remember, if you clashed like dice against a gun card, it gets recycled.
Yes, but not getting hit by this will be difficult because it's three dice.
Yeah, but again, if you clash against a gun card, it recycles.
Mm-hmm.
So like, for example, go to like Gim.
Oh, you for mean example, I can extreme edge that?
I mean, you probably want to do it against a big one. Like, the one below. The one that has bleed. You probably want to use... Wait, you can use Transpierce against that one, right?
Against that one?
Yeah.
For sure.
And then
yeah, use... that's better.
Yeah. And then use... Flying sword against the big one.
And... Oh god, this will be awkward.
You can use flying sword against that one. That will probably win all of them.
I only have one flying sword.
Yeah, but then you can extreme mess the one on top. That's reliable, right? Because the
oh, that's also gone.
Like, the rolls on the right one are, like, lower, right?
Slightly, but yes. This is all a gun.
Yeah, it's all gun. So it's easier to like, you know.
Oh.
Recycle.
Do I need to do anything else this turn or?
That no, they don't have to do anything else. You just have to win the clashes. I guess wins.
One. Two.
Wins. That was high. You get 3 scenes to try it again, so I think they will use the same card.
Yeah.
Does Kim have It doesn't have to come on fast.
Three to eight. How does this start? Well, 3 to 8. Okay, this will be very luck based.
Refine could work.
The slash dice.
Sparking spear. Or eject. Eject reduced their die by one, right?
Eject is probably better.
You have like a lower max roll, but. Maybe. Wait, no, not that one, because the block die in the last one is like annoying. So yeah, one sparking spear instead.
Well, let's try it.
You're getting real lucky with these rolls. Okay, well, one more turn.
Welcome to my life.
Does Kim have like a one cost? Overcome crisis to win. This will definitely work. You get a plus 5 power. Okay. Now you can hurt Knight of Despair.
Okay.
I think you can do a energy cycle into rift based combo in this turn. Or dimension. Yeah. You can do a rift based combo.
Yep. Rift space here. Then we can literally just go bonkers.
Yeah, just remember next turn, yeah, like do the thing again. If you don't kill her.
Yeah, well, I was about to say, not if I kill her.
I doubt you will kill her. Oh my god, if you actually kill her, it'll be really funny.
Trust! Okay, I will not kill her.
You know.
It would have been very funny if I did.
Then choose whatever.
Justice on you. Well, you only have one life, that's kind of sad.
I don't have energy psych. I just sleep and you maybe get rip space next turn. I don't know. Or energy psych.
I could de-rift into leap, yeah.
Yeah, probably that's better. It sucks. Wait, don't you have draw of the sword too? In Tifraf's hand?
Huh?
Tifraf's hand. Doesn't Tifraf have a light card too?
What card?
Tifraf.
I have no idea.
Does Tifraf have a light card? Tifraf.
Ah, Tifraf.
Not Haru, Tifraf. Yeah, she's draw of the sword, a light card. Use it.
I was not ready with my. Was not done with my rotation yet.
Oh, I thought. Oh, because you used trans.
I first look at all the clashes and then I go for the other. That's why I was so confused.
Draw.
Whatever.
Nice.
I wish it was not a health blue shine.
Now I can go funny on it.
Yeah, now I can just transpierce it. Actually, I want to prescript it instead.
Yeah, you can draw. And I gain the juicy light. It's a poly stagger and then proceed to the next phase.
Yeah. Probably.
So maybe save the other card for next turn. You can also save Rift Space for next turn.
Yep. And to make that even better, let us
Do you really want to use that? Oh wait, Rift Space had 2 costs, so yeah, it's fine.
I would have 2 light next turn and 10 charge.
I keep forgetting Rift Space is a 2 cost card.
It is really ridiculous for a 2 cost, to be fair.
you don't get staggered.
Haha, funny.
Probably should have faith dashed that. Anyway. Ow.
That's actually good.
Hope the god they don't target Kim, all of them.
Well, that I can intercept. I can ripple that into energy cycle. And nothing I can do about that.
Well, you could have used your life cards.
Speed. I could have used my light cards, but I can also just keep them. Oh my god.
And now it's switched over, so.
Yeah. Tifereth just decided to not hit a single hit. That was pretty
sad. Just use Revive and extract fuel.
I mean, extract fuel is a given here.
Like, maybe try Clash. Maybe take over Clash with someone else so Tifereth can get free hits in instead of losing.
Yeah, I don't think I want to clash with Kim.
I mean, Kim has pretty nice rolls. Like, what does Kim have? Draw off the sword to win against that one.
Yeah.
On the first one.
Yeah, that's true. I can clash with this one. And then make sure that... In that case, I want to do a big one. Yeah.
On the other one?
I'm thinking right now. Yeah, Refine will probably be better.
Take over the Clash of Kim, though, if you're done later.
Yeah. Can already do it now.
And do you have Energy Cycle with,
Luckily, I do. Also, I need to make sure that Kim is not getting attacked, so... It might be better to use Leap here and Energy Cycle there.
That will probably lose. That will get enough by the evade die, I think. Okay, stagger, never mind. You got lucky. Never mind.
I never get lucky. That's the one thing you need to understand.
Because you clashed Energy Cycle against the evade die.
I couldn't have done another way in a way that worked, so whatever. Well, that's still... Oh, wait! I still have a turn to do nothing with.
Well, I need to kill one.
I technically need to kill one, yeah. I have so much shit. I need to watch out that... Oh, yeah, of course. What? Who else? 3-hit, 2-hit, Flying Sword. If he loses, if Nox loses one clash, he's dead.
Just use Sharpened Blade against the staggered one.
That's a fair point. Otherwise, I would be confirmed to lose that. I could Drift.
Wait, can I... Wait, let me check. So, imagine if he did rolled all max. 5 times 2 is 10, 10. So, if even if he rolled max like 3 times, it won't kill Tifereth.
Oh, that's a scary leap. Yeah, whatever.
Okay, Kim gaming time. Kim is your only hope, or reliable hope. Okay, nice. Yes, yes, yes. Overcome Crisis and Extreme Ash.
Yeah, Extreme Ash goes there, right? Or does it go here?
Unless, that one is like 100% win. So you can do that. And what can clash against that? Rift Space.
With my Rift Space luck, are you sure? Well, let's try it anyway.
Bonk.
Wow, it actually worked for the first time.
Oh, you won. Yoshi was at low HP, so you won, basically.
Oh my god. That wasn't an annoying fight, I tell you that.
Realization gets is much easier, because you know, you can actually like kill her in the first phase.
확실히 특이점은 도시를 이해하는 데 있어 큰 변수지. 그런데 사서의 정의가 어렵다는 건? 그 부분은 나도 솔직히 궁금해서.
사서를 뭐라 생각해?
인간은 아니지만
People tend to books, maybe?
모든 사서는 도서관 안에서만 존재할 수 있어. 지정 사서와 보조 사서는 로보토미에서 일하던 세피라와 직원이라는 원본이 있는 존재지.
They're canon. The employees you have in the bottom corrupt.
예전 로보토미사의 직원들이 다시 육체를 부여받고 일을 할 수 있는 거야. 엔젤라는 분명 약속을 지켰지. 하지만 세피라와 직원만 부활한 게 아니야. 환상체도 함께 부활했지. 로보토미의 시설 대부분이 무너지고 빛과 전투로 에너지를 소모해버려서 물리적인 육체를 유지하고 있지 못하지만 사서들은 육체를 복원했지만 정신적으로 불안정하고 그래서 사서들은 환상체를 짊어지고 손님과 싸우는 거야. 우리도 마찬가지고.
그런 거였구만. 그래도 환상체라는 존재한테 힘을 빌린다는 느낌이었지 먹힌다는 느낌은 아니었어. 문득 어떤 선을 넘을 것 같을 때가 있긴 했지만
그 선을 넘으면 뒤틀림이라고 불리는 현상이 되는 거야. 엔젤라가 그 선을 넘지 않도록 조절하고 있는 거고.
뭔가 무대 위에서 춤추는 꼴 같군.
그 말대로야. 이번에는 우리가 무대 위에 있는 것 같아.
엔젤라 나름의 복수일까?
그럴지도.
근데 나는 대체 왜 휘말려야 하지?
손님을 응대하는 과정에서 나와 보조사서들이 끔찍하게 죽는다 해도 도서관이 폐관을 하면 다시 형태를 갖추고 잠에서 깨어나. 하지만 손님을 응대할 때는 언제나 고통과 죽음에 대한 두려움을 느껴. 왜 그런지 알아?
잊어버리기 때문이지.
맞아. 사서들은 손님을 응대하는 시점에서 죽어도 다시 깨어날 수 있다는 것을 잊게 돼. 손님과 같은 처절한 마음으로 서로를 상대해야만 하는 거야. 매번 죽음에 대한 두려움과 고통을 각오한 채 손님들을 마주하는 거지. 어때? 도서관의 초대가 이래도 치사하다고 생각해?
뭐 충분히 공평하지. 그래도 우리는 다시 되살아나기라도 하잖아. 결과적으로 죽는 순간에 모른다는 건 둘째 치더라도. 그러니 마냥 치사하지 않다고 할 순 없겠는걸. 폐관 후에 우리는 고통을 잊는다지만 아픔을 느꼈단 사실은 존재하잖아. 이 무대 위에서 놀아나게 하는 엔젤라가 원망스럽진 않은 거야?
더 고통스럽게 할 수 있다면 진작에 했겠지. 엔젤라는 나름의 배려를 해주고 있는 것 같아. 예전 로보토미에서 직원은 말 그대로 소모품이었어. 다른 기업들과 같이. 하지만 적어도 여기서 사서는 버려지지 않아. 누구도 버려지지 않지.
버려지지는 않는다라. 뭐 어떻게든 좋게 보려고 하는 게 티페리트의 장점이네.
이게 다 관록이지.
난 가끔 도서관에서 눈을 감았다가 깨어날 때 다시는 깨어나고 싶지 않다는 생각을 해. 아니, 이곳에서 뿐만이 아니었지. 밖에서도 늘 그려왔어. 잠에서 깨지 않았더라면 싶었지.
어째서?
삐걱거리는 몸을 일으켜 아무 기대 없는 하루를 다시 시작해야 하니까.
기대가 없다고?
맞아. 무언가에 대한 기대 따위는 진작에 버렸지. 나 자신이나 이 돌아가는 세상은 결국 몰락할 거야. 너희가 말하던 그 마음의 병을 심하게 앓고 있는지도 모르겠다.
난 우리가 좀 더 나아질 거라고 믿고 있어.
허, 믿는 건 자유니까. 그럼 무대 위에서 춤출 준비를 하러 가볼까?
Alright, that was an interesting scene.
Time.
Well, we get more stuff. Alright, abnormality pages for Floor of Natural Sciences. Is there even nature in this world? Anyway,
the rules fucked up.
Blessing. If a character took damage from attacks on a previous scene, change this character's resistances against the type that dealt the most damage to endure from a scene. That's interesting.
That's nice.
Despair. Oh, that's an all allies card. Whenever an ally dies, okay, that's already a card I don't want to use. All of our allies gain 1 to 3 strength and haste, and all enemies are inflicted with 2 fragile. Still, I don't want to use that, because I don't want librarians to die. And blades wetted by teardrops. On a successful pierce attack, if a die rolled max value, deal bonus damage equal to 10% of a target's max HP. Maximum 12. Sad.
Big sad.
Eugen's crying in a corner right now. Alright. Ooh, Star of the City. Another chapter. I try calling each star something beautiful. Well, that's the most hopeful thing I've seen so far.
도시는 오늘도 욕망이 넘실거리며 빠른거리는군.
늘 이 모습 그대로 인간들은 이야기를 엮어야 하지.
오늘 도서관이라는 별 하나가 하늘에 떴어. 이 별은 어떤 꿈으로 도시를 비출까?
이 별이 부디 도시의 달콤한 꿈을 깨우지 않기를.
아까부터 뭘 그렇게 열심히 적고 있어?
모든 일을 끝내고 이곳에서 나갔을 때 하고 싶은 걸 적는 중이야.
굉장히 빽빽한데?
미트 스튜 먹는 것도 제대로 적었어.
정말 기억해줬구나?
난 뭐든지 기억할 수 있으니까.
그러면 굳이 적을 필요 없지 않아? 아, 물론 기분 상하게 하려는 뜻은 아니야.
사실 잊지 않으려고 적는 거 맞아.
어?
뭐? 그럼
정말 인간이 가까워지고 있나 봐. 내 기억들이 완전하진 않아도 점차 옅어지는 게 느껴져. 이런 적은 처음이야. 지워야 할 기억들이 아직도 까마득하게 남았지만.
그래도 여러모로 축하해. 간절히 원하던 거잖아.
고마워. 그래서 이제는 다음이라는 걸 꿈꾸기 위해 이 종이에 적는 거야. 네가 말한 울타리, 그런 거지.
꿈이라.
롤랑, 너는 어때? 이곳에서 나가면 어떤 것부터 하고 싶어?
글쎄, 일단 해결사 일은 접을까 생각 중이야. 여러모로 지쳤거든.
그래? 네가 어떤 해결사였는지는 몰라도 곁에서 지켜본 바로는 적성에 맞아 보이는데. 잘 싸우는 건 그렇다 쳐도 여러 상황에 대처하고 능숙하게 일을 받아 넘기는 걸 보면 네 말대로 꽤 잘 나갔을 것 같아. 그런 점이야말로 해결사의 미덕처럼 보였거든.
하긴 내가 생각해도 해결사만큼 잘 맞는 일은 없을 것 같다. 그래도 이제는 좀 쉬고 싶어. 이 정도가 적당해. 다른 사람을 위해서 누군가의 피를 보는 일은.
그래서 어떤 일을 하고 싶어?
그렇게 집요하게 물어봐도 말이지 이곳의 일이 끝난다면... 아, 정말 생각 안 나네.
정 없으면 내 일을 도와줄래? 이번에는 정식으로 고용할게. 일에 맞는 보수도 지급해줄 수 있어.
어떤 일인데?
뭐겠어. 이 종이에 적은 것들이지.
아까도 말했지만...
피를 보는 일들은 아니야. 나도 피를 보는 건 이제 충분해. 네 말대로 다음이라는 걸 생각해보니 떠오르는 게 자유더라고. 복수를 이룬 후에 자유를 얻고 별탈 없이 세상을 돌아다니면 좋겠다 싶었어.
그래도 무사히 여행을 마치도록 호위해달라는 건...
무슨 소리야. 내 몸 정도는 스스로 지킬 수 있어. 말동무나 해주면 돼. 지금까지 온 손님을 보니 너보다 잘 맞을 것 같은 친구는 없을 것 같아서.
친구인가?
내 일방적인 착각인가? 내가 아는 사람은 정말 적거든. 그 몇 없는 사람들조차 못 볼 꼴만 봐야 했지. 서로 정해진 배역을 무대 위에서 연기할 뿐이었으니까. 그들에게 결국 나는 대본을 읊기 위한 도구이자 기계. 그 이상 그 이하도 아니었어.
사사들, 아니 세피라와 직원들 말이구나.
다른 곳에서 다른 형태로 만났다면 동료가 됐을 수는 있겠네. 그래서 어떻게 생각해?
응?
이곳의 일이 끝나는 말이야.
아, 그 이야기는 긍정적으로 검토해볼게. 나쁘지는 않겠어. 다 내려놓고 세상을 돌아다녀 보는 것도.
More cost
passive
limits.
Transfer cost limit has increased from 8 to 10.
Yes.
Alright. Confirm.
철학의 층.
Oh god, another scene.
사선은 비나라.
Yeah.
Oh boy, it's Bina.
여기는 헤스드랑 다른 냄새를 풍기는데?
홍차는 의미란다.
Her.
And I already love her for Black Tea.
좋은 향이구만.
그렇단다. 파란머리 도련님은 아직 제대로 된 홍차 맛을 모를 테지.
이곳은 다른 층과 다르게 위압감이 느껴져. 철학이라는 주제랑 뭔가 맞네. 무슨 말 하는지도 모르겠고 말도 무겁고.
네가 보는 도서관은 어떠니?
내가 보는 도서관?
사람들의 피를 마시는 죽음의 공간인지, 정보를 축적하는 지식의 첨탑인지, 혹은 새로운 삶을 위한 방주일지.
내가 본 도서관은... 투기장? 엔젤라든 사서든 각자 원하는 것을 어떻게든 쟁취하려는 곳이야. 그래서 굉장히 치열하지. 피가 튀고.
네가 바라보는 도서관은 그렇구나. 그렇다면 너에게 있어 도서관은 어떤 곳이니?
나한테는 뭐 감옥이지.
그렇게 보이지 않는구나. 넌 기회를 잡으려 하고 있어.
당연히 여기서 나갈 기회를 잡아야지.
네가 그렇다면 그런 것이겠지.
뭐야 넌 대체? 다 아는 듯한 말이나 하고.
난 비나란다.
아니, 넌 지금까지 만난 사사들과 풍기는 냄새가 달라.
첫 번째 삶에서 어떤 존재였는지가 궁금한 것이구나.
그래, 넌 대체 누구야?
머리의 조율자였단다.
뭐라고?
난 일어난 지 얼마 되지 않았단다. 이 차와 함께 마음을 추슬러야 하니 다음에 다시 찾아오려무나. 책도 잊지 말고.
잠깐.
Well, we did hear about an arbiter showing up from Hod.
Really strong.
Well, I can imagine her being strong if she's a mother hecking arbiter.
Oh, that's a bit weird. Bina has a luck. You can't use her yet.
I can't use Bina in her own floor. Well, that seems nice.
She's just taking her team.
I guess I'm not using Bina for a while. What?
She doesn't have any updates at all, so like, I don't think you have any reason not to. Because yeah. next chapter has pretty harsh perceptions.
Oh hey, I technically have this. I just need to do the reception again.
Yeah.
Because I used all of them to get the key page. Huh.
You can just do it off screen, Bully.
Yeah, I'll do the farming off screen anyways. And holy hell, level 48 for the next chapter.
Yeah.
How many invitations are there? Yeah, okay, 4. That's what I expected.
4. You can look at the required pages or books.
I mean, this one's probably Crying Children. Yep. This will probably be Walkrew and Rose. Or just Walkrew. That's fine by me too. This one's probably one of the Smiles. Oh, and Distortion. Okay, this scares me a little bit then. And this one's probably Index Boils. Yeah. Not too hard to guess, right? It's pretty linear.
Sometimes it changes what you need.
But yeah, that's all still very far gone from what we're gonna do.
This chapter is pretty long, so...
There's still a lot of abnormality fights to do before we get there. With a lot, I mean, Ha, Netze, and Chisette. Yep. Then maybe another round for Tifereth and Chesset, depending on how that goes. Yeah, that's all. That's all for this episode, at least. We got the new chapter. We got a team mummy. Yep.
It will take a while before we start one chapter, but it will happen eventually.
It will happen eventually. Eventually, we will see what.
Depends if you want charge support as soon as possible, and then you can do one chapter.
Yeah, I just want to finish at least the lower of Hod and Netzech first, and maybe get Chesset's second abnormality pages before I go for the first reception in Star of the City. But that's all a discussion for later.
That's all then.
Yeah. So, hope you guys enjoyed. And see you in the next episode when we finally
do
more stuff. Have a great day. Bye bye.